What is going on, guys? Apathy here, back with another video. Today we are playing COG on Evac Uplink, but better yet, it is the Mind of Apathy episode 2, where I give you guys some strategy and pro tips as the game goes on. And better than that, we actually win 25-2, I believe. So the uplink score, the way we win, is seriously insane. So let's get right to this video, and if you love it, man, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. So to start off, I'm going to try to warrant this. I'm going to easily miss it. So I'm going to warrant the back, guys. It's a great way of getting this one. I'm going to immediately jump off as soon as I spot someone and really just hit that one. I get taken out. But the main goal there was to get a one. Now, on this part, on this side, if we have no control of tree, if this is the last guy, you want to wrap the ball. If you guys didn't know, wrapping the ball was the best way, is the best way to play this side. Because on this side, it is considered bad side. And the best thing to do always is to buy time. You don't necessarily have to score too much on this side. You shouldn't have to, like, when something's considered bad side, your goal should be to either tie or win or go next side by a point or two. Obviously, you get more is better, but it's not necessarily a huge thing. Now, here I push out glass because this is the control we want, but my teammate ends up missing the one, which I believe was John. So now we're forced to rotate and follow this guy. Usually, when you wrap the ball, the good thing about it is you force one or two of their players to chase the ball guy. But John missing that one kind of screwed us, but we end up stopping their point at least. And now here, Med John gets a kill, JCAG gets a kill. I push down middle because it's too dead. I can easily pinch this. Only problem is someone's probably going to spawn out and watch it. Obviously a smart thing to do, which Remy does. Good play by him. And then I die. It was a kind of useless death, but it was better than not doing anything. So right here, I believe we're going to wrap the ball, but then Slasher ends up getting a two-piece. He gets three. So on this side, usually what you want to do is try to get ones. It's so hard to get twos, and obviously racking these ones are so important. So John immediately throws the one since we have control, gets that up 2-0 right now. He gets the kill on the uplink portal. And a big thing is when you guys get in a spawn trap, you want to block that tree spawn because they can literally spawn right there. I immediately look behind me, make sure I'm blocking it, don't want them to be there. I think JCAT messes up his wall run, but luckily he still hits the one. This part, I need to get kills. I played this pretty dumb, I'm not gonna lie. I should definitely be like in a head glitch or in a corner or laying down waiting for them. I was just out in the open giving them a pretty much a free kill. I could have got maybe one kill, but it was still, I made it pretty hard on myself. Right here, like I said, wrap the ball. It's bad side. We just want to buy time. We don't necessarily have to force anything. We want to force them out of their positions so we can get this right side control. So like the main thing is when wrapping the ball is you want to wrap the ball to push out glass and push out tree and get this control. I think I'll play this guy, throw a nade, immediately rush to the right, catch him off guard, pick up aches, try to play my life. I know they're going to be on me. I forced two people to look at me, bought a little bit more extra seconds, but I died. Now, the good thing is they only had like one player pushed up. John has heat wave. We all have a specialist. We really don't want to get into spawn trap. My teammates did a great job of rotating back, not worrying too much about OE, and John does a great job getting the two-piece. I pick up the third kill. Last kid's behind us. That's four dead. Now, I was about to pick a ball, but first guy should slay. Third or fourth guy should always pick up the ball. First two people in front, slay. Don't be one of those guys who just love picking up balls. Like, I know some of you out there are like that, guys, but can't be like that. So right here, I get the nade, try to get this kill. So close getting that kill, but there was two of them. Ace ends up shooting me on the side. Now, we're in a great position. Up 4-1 on bad side. You can see our teammate immediately picks a ball and tries to rotate it around because that's what you want to do. You want to buy time. We're up 4-1 on bat side. They have full tree control. Now we get them out of their position again. Me and JCAP, whoever's with me, are working the right side. I pick up the first kill. I decide, you know what? I'm going to help this guy get the points. He immediately spots me, so I force two guys to look at me. JCAP camels in. Guaranteed two. Usually, that's the best way to do it, to get a two. Either you get all four in your spawn, or you rotate ball, and you know, and you get the kills like trying to stop you, because it's usually gonna be two guys. You're usually when rotating the ball are gonna force one to two guys to come back to you. So therefore, it's possible to get that too. But like I said, usually on this side is bad side. You want to just rack points, get ones. You know, you shouldn't force too much. So as you guys can see, bad side. We're up 7-1. 40 seconds left. Slasher is pretty much guaranteed an easy one because our teammate distracts them. They're out of position. And like if you notice throughout this round, this side, we wrap the ball a lot. I was about to wrap the ball here again, but John managed, or I think, yeah, John gets a two-piece. So I'm like, why not? Let's just try to work this. They wanted to work it. Slasher gets a two-piece. And like I said, wrapping the ball, if you guys notice, we wrapped a lot. We forced them out of position many times. We pretty much had control of the map the whole time. Now, right here, I was going to wall run low, but I guess like it's blocked by a tree. So I'm like, fuck, I'm just going to buy time for my team. We're up 8-1. We can't get any points in realistically, so I don't want to force anything. Right here, I try to go for this one slasher told me about that I've never done in my life, but I decided to try it. Almost went in, and that was a great first side. So a great tip I could give you on this side is teams usually are used to go middle with ball, but now they're starting to wrap it all the way around, or they might four push tree. So I stuck the ball guy, rush in automatically, pick up the two piece, kinetic right away, shoot the guy on my right, pick up the three piece, one guy comes up, all methods. Wow, Apathy picks up a four piece, pure disgusting. So this four piece literally opens up the map. Make sure to leave a like after you saw that. I'm just kidding, guys. But that four piece opens up the map. We guaranteed a one. And now me and JCap's goal right here is to slay. JCap picks up kill. I picked up kill earlier. We're trying to work together. I pick up the guy in the back. There's one more guy. JCap dies, but I'm pretty sure that Methods guy gets traded by my teammate. There it goes. Slasher picks it up. Now, if I try to stay alive back here because I want these streaks. I'm 100 off. Unfortunately, I didn't catch the ball earlier. If I would have caught it, I could have got the two here. I possibly could have got that two, but I wanted to get streaks, and that's just being greedy. You guys got to, especially a lot of you amateur players in uplink, guys, you can't be greedy. And that's a problem I had in the beginning of AW because uplink was new to me, obviously. But I was greedy a lot of times when I'm like, I could get this two, I could get this two. Just go for the one. It's better to be safe than sorry. I'm pretty sure you guys heard this before. But now this is where I start racking points. They try to OE, I believe, this one time. And it's a good play by them. They all OE. JCap does a good job picking up the ball, and we just push out. And I believe I stop. I think JCap dies, but I trade that kill right here. I just rush out, trade that kill, and it almost stops their OE. I believe there's only like one guy here. I do a good job of picking up him as well. And that's pretty much that's it. Now the last two try to rotate back. Slasher picks up one because it's a good position. I think about pulling my lightning here, but I'm like, all right, Slasher's a good position. We can just slay. I decide, you know what, I decide I'm going to call it here because I can't get that guy out of the barrel. Slasher's busy and he dies, so might as well use it. I get the lightning. We get one dead. John picks the ball right away. There's a Serpy in front of him. I pick up this kill right here. And right now what they're trying to do is they're trying to wrap back. Obviously, you know, we're up by a lot. They probably don't care as much at this point. But a good tip I could give you guys on this situation is, yes, you can all wrap back, but if you're going to wrap back, all of you have to wrap back. You guys can't be cheating the rotation. Two of you should be going all around the back. Two of you should be going, like, one in laundry, one towards middle, and try to cut the guys off. Right here, third or fourth guy, like I told you in Fringe, if you watch episode one, should be watching the pinch. So I always EMP check on this map. I just throw EMP at the big door. If someone's pinching, like you guys saw, then it's obviously a hit marker's going to come up. I'm like, oh, shit, someone's pinching. Most of the time, that's how I check the pinch, or sometimes I was just preempt a little bit, see nothing, then I'll push up. But back to what I was saying. So there's three ways, or two ways, realistically, of breaking that spawn trap. You either all OE like they did once, it didn't work, so they didn't do it again, but it was probably their best bet, or they two all have to rotate back, play it really smart, really well, no shortcuts, go all the way around. And since they OE'd once, you know, it didn't work well, we did a good job of stopping the OE. They decide to try to keep wrapping back, and right here, all I have to do is buy time for my teammate, Kinetic, immediately kill BL Fire, and it allows my team to just hit that one, and we're just racking up points. I still have Kinetics, so I just jump out, challenge Methods, and we're just doing a good job of spawn trapping them. And here, I'm just trying to wall run high, get high position on the enemies, but pretty much, a huge thing CLG messed up was just, you know, like I said, we got him in this nasty spawn trap, and this is why I consider it a good side. I don't know what the fuck I was doing there. That was just retarded by me. But, I mean, we're up by a lot, so I guess I didn't care as much anymore. But, you know, like I said, we're on the good side. This is why it's considered a good side, because you can easily get him in a nasty spawn trap. And, you know, it is about winning clutch gunfights, and it is clutch situation. But you guys got to understand that if you're going to wrap back, you guys have to do it as a team. And two players should be going all the way around, especially a sub and AR. And then two players should be going towards laundry in the middle. You shouldn't cheat the rotations. Or you can all OE. If it doesn't work once, then, you know, it kind of sucks. But sometimes you just need to do it for a second time. So right here, we're up 25-1. We're like, I'm just drinking. I'm sipping on my monster. I'm like, holy shit, this shit is over. Great dominance for my team. We haven't won an uplink like this in a while. Usually we win by like 5-10 points max. But this was a really dominant gameplay. We got him in a nasty spawn trap. And I hope you guys learned a couple things, you know, like we did. Just getting the spawn trap, if you guys want to rewatch it again, it's all about just getting that pillar control, slaying them, and then keep holding that position. And if you notice, and then if, like, when you get in a spawn trap, like my teammates did, one wrap wraps back to ball, and then one's by him just in case to watch the OE. Especially if we have control of the spawn, that's exactly how you want to hold it. So make sure just to, I mean, I'm not saying rewatch it, but hope you guys really pay attention how we held that spawn trap. And I hope you guys, that made me chuckle, but I hope you guys gave you some good advice, you know, on the map. And hope you guys learned a couple new things. This has been your boy, Apathy. I hope you all have a great day. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. And don't forget, I have some more of these on my channel. This has been your boy, Apathy, and I'm out. Peace.